Hi. Creating a rigid form out of a thin, delicate shape like a flower can be extremely challenging. But Smooth-On has this fantastic new coating product. It works better than anything else I've tried. You can apply it to many different kinds of surfaces, from 3D printed parts to fabrics, and it creates a clear, smooth, firm result. You may be interested in this process for all kinds of different applications, from creating jewelry to fashion pieces. You could use it to form sculptural elements for home decoration, fine art, or you could even creatively display your bridal bouquet. Okay, let's get started. I'm wearing gloves for this project, and I've coated my table surface with a cellophane so that any mess I make will be easy to clean up. XTC 3D has a mix ratio of two parts A to one part B. So I'm going to take my part A, which is the bigger bottle, and pour a small amount of it out. In the same size container, these clear little containers I'm using, they're disposable and clean, I'm going to dispense my part B. But this time, I'm only going to use half as much as I poured into the part A. This way I'm keeping to my 2-to-1 ratio. You can see that the part B has a slightly yellow coloration, but when it's mixed and applied in thin sections, the coating appears clear. The liquid coating is really easy to mix since it has a super low viscosity. And it is possible to color this material with Smooth-On So Strong color tints to change the appearance of your flower, but for this example, I just love seeing the color of the fabric come through. I'm only going to need a small amount to coat the entire flower, so I'll take a little of my brush and spread it onto each petal. Gravity is going to help it flow down inside the flower. XTC 3D has a pot life of 10 minutes, so I'm using these flat wide cups to keep the material thin and to extend its pot life, so I have lots of time to coat the surface. Since the silk fabric is thin, it becomes translucent when it's saturated with this coating. I can clearly see the spots that I've missed, so I'm going to go back in and press some more material against the back of each petal as well, just to make sure I have it completely covered. Sometimes I wrap the flower stem with aluminum foil to hold back the leaves temporarily so the resin doesn't drip onto them by accident while I'm working. You can already see that high gloss on the surface of the flower itself. And it's going to retain that glossy quality after the material cures. By turning it upside down, I can let some of the excess resin drip off really easily. Then I can turn it upright again to take its final shape. While I have it upside down, I'm going to add a little more material to the back of these small, delicate leaves, just to add some additional support. So it doesn't significantly deform the rose petal shape with the weight of the resin, and I can leave the piece and allow it to cure for 4 hours to perfectly take on this form with only one coat of resin. Now that it's been 4 hours, let's take a look at our flower. It's cured rigid and doesn't change shape when I handle it. It's absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much for watching, and good luck with your projects.